The calendar tool provides you 5 different views. These views are different layouts for events in the calendar content area. This tutorial will explain what is displayed in the calendar content and how to navigate each view. To get to the calendar, click on the calendar tab on the nav bar. Now at the top of the calendar, you will see the different calendar views. Whichever one you last visited will be the default when you enter the calendar the next time. So what I'm going to do is explain each view, what is displayed in it, and how to navigate it. The first view, the agenda view. What's displayed in the agenda view? The agenda view displays full details of the event, of events. For example, if the event is a Dropbox, like you can see here, you'll see all the directions for the item, and then you'll be even able to click on the item and it will take you into the course content area. So when I click on that, notice the breadcrumb links changed because I'm actually in the content of the course. So the agenda view provides the student with that ability to be able to click right on it. If you added start, do, or end dates to a module or a sub-module, then the entire module or sub-module contents will be displayed. Each item within the module or sub-module will allow the students to click on the item and will take them into the course contents. So in this case, this was a single discussion, but in this case, I added a sub-module. This is the name of the sub-module, and I'm able to even click on the content within that sub-module and it will take me to that. So the agenda view provides that kind of way of looking around. Now, you're going to see these two arrows, this right and left arrow, on each one of the views. By default, the agenda view shows you the events for today and tomorrow. If I click on the right arrow, it'll show me the items for the next 7 days. So you'll see the next 7 days. If I click on it on the right arrow again, it goes to the next 14 days. So clicking the left or right arrow will toggle between these displays. You can change how the events are grouped in the agenda view by date, course, or category. Clicking on one of these will change the event group. By default, it's chronologically by date. But if I wanted to look by course, if I have multiple course calendars up, I can do that. But what's also interesting is by category. So there's a Dropbox, there's a discussion, there's a quiz, and there's a module. So however you decide to group them, it will be that way. The next view is the day view. This will then what will be displayed in the calendar content. The day view displays the events for a single day. If you click on the event, you'll see more details. So if I click on the event, I'll see more details. I can also edit and delete the event here, but I can also click on the more. If I click on more, it will take me into a view where I can see everything like the agenda view and I can click on it. And then I use the breadcrumb link to go back to the day view. Now again, I have these arrows, and if I click on the left or right arrow, it will take me to the next day or take me to the previous day. If I want to click back to today, I can do that. Now along with that, I can use the mini calendar, which is right here, and I can click on any day there and it will take me to that day directly without me having to click the left or right arrow. The next view is the week view. And the week view is similar to the day view. It will show you, let me go back to this week, it'll show you the events for the entire, for a given week. If you click on the event, again, the same thing, you're going to see more details. I can click more, again, using the breadcrumb links, takes me back into the calendar. I can click the left and right arrow to navigate between the various weeks. Or again, since I'm in the week view, I can use the mini calendar and click on any day within that week and it'll show me the events for that week. The same thing with the month view. In the month view, again, you're going to see the events for the entire month. And again, you have the same kind of navigation and the same kind of controls where I can click there, click more. I can now click on the little arrow, go to month. I can click on the right and left arrows up here to navigate between this month and the previous months. The last view is called the list view. The list view is a little different. So this displays the events as a list. So you can see it's just a general list of all the events that the student has in this one particular course. If you click on an event, so I'll click on an event, it will give you more details. If I click on the breadcrumb links, it'll take me back. Now, one of the other things that you can do in this view is you can filter. So I can filter just by drop boxes and discussions. And if I don't want to see that, I can click clear all filters. So I can choose various items to let me filter down to the various items that I want to see. How do I navigate? Well, by default, you're going to see all events. If I click previous, you're going to see only the upcoming events, so the ones that events that are happening. If I click again, it'll show me the past events, any event that has already passed in terms of its dates. And again, clicking would show me all events. So those are the various views. You choose whatever view you want to be your default. And when you click back in the calendar, so if I click list view and I go back to the course home and I click calendar, it'll take me back to the list view, and whatever navigation I've used, it will also remember that too. So it's your choice in which view you want, but that's how the different calendar views work for you as an instructor, and the same for students.